From there, now! By the prophet's ass, 1 second later and I would have been scraping your remains off the floor. What in blazes are you doing here anyway? Let's put it this way. I know how to hide when I don't want to be seen. And concerning the explosion, you stepped right into a Kyrenian dust crystal. Get a little too close and wait a little too long, and you'll have your ass blown around your ears by an explosion that would put any cannon to shame. Lashiri? Oh my, the fellow really isn't one for names, is he? I'm Lashiri, but never mind that. At least it proves you're not lying. Anyhow, I hope you're not the backup I asked for. I was hoping for someone more, impressive. No offense. Is that so? Indeed. You have some uncontrolled magic inside you. And quite a lot of uncontrolled magic. Not bad. I've never felt anything like this before. Very well. If Constantine insists, I will perform the ritual on you. But it'll have to wait, since I'm up to my neck in this shit, as you've probably noticed. Short version or long version? Which do you prefer? Fine. I suppose you already know that that is me, my assistant, 2 Arcanists, and 4 Keepers, are here to do research on... well, on something, which is exactly what we've done these past weeks. But, as I went upstairs to get something a couple hours ago, I suddenly heard screaming and the clanging of metal coming from downstairs. As I looked for cover, I saw these 2 shapes in red robes vanishing into the lower parts of the ruin. I have no idea who they are or why they're here, but to me, they look like mercenaries. Anyway, fact is, my esteemed Indralayan colleagues and my assistant are still down there, together with our research, and I want them back. And before you ask, yes, you can help me. You'll have to, actually, if you want me to tame your magic. I wouldn't have a chance fighting the mercenaries by myself, but the 2 of us might be able to do it, provided you can defend yourself, which I'm quite sure you can. What do you say? Are you ready? No idea, but I don't think there are more than 12. Also, they don't anticipate any resistance, which is to our advantage. Oh, that's hard to explain. But part of it is finding the answer to the universal question. Why do some people have the nerve to ask irrelevant questions when shit is going down around them? After we've cleaned up the mess, we can do this whole, who are you and what are you doing here thing if you want to. But this really isn't the time. No idea. But I don't think there are more than 12. Also, they don't anticipate any- Fine, then follow me. And keep your weapons ready. I think I just heard footsteps down there. Stabbed like a pig. Hang on. What's this? By the prophet's ass. I don't believe it. Their orders. My assistant, Sev. It seems he's the reason these fuckers managed to take us by surprise. Save it for Sev when I shove the staff up his ass and fire a thunderbolt. Thank you. shit, can you smell that? That's fire. So, these guys really are trying to destroy our research. We have to do something. You're adept at magic, right? Take this spell and use it to put out the fires. If I'm right, the mercenaries are trying to destroy the stone fragments, and we have to stop them. You take the lower part of the ruin. Try to save as many stones as you can. I'll take the upper part, and when it's all done, we'll meet here again. Oh, and one more thing. If you should find my assistant Sev down there, try to take him alive and bring him to me. I want to take care of him myself, okay? Then let's get going.
Ha! might be known.
Well, I'll be damned. That's what I call good timing. I take it you were successful? What about the fragments? Did you save them? Well, I guess that'll have to do. Thanks. What about Sev? Did you find him? Fuck. That little shit. I was hoping I could make him tell us who's behind all this. Well, whatever. No use crying over spilt milk, I guess. What's your name, anyway? Amidst all this, we didn't have time for formalities. You're pleased? Well, that's good to hear. I actually had the feeling that I was a little rough on you. Sorry for that, really. Sometimes I just have a short fuse. Anyway, let's talk about the reason you're here. For starters, tell me how you managed to get the old Ranter to trust you. That doesn't happen very often. I've got time. So, you're saying that you learned all this, the magic, the swordplay, in such a short time? That's fascinating, to say the least. And these visions, if I understand correctly, you foresaw the death of the two apothecary? It does indeed. But hey, who am I to judge? Here you are, the mysterious stranger who appeared out of thin air and, without much fuss, took out an entire group of sellswords. And even better, now you tell me that these skills come from studying magic for only a couple of weeks, and that you can see the future. You certainly are full of shit. Not you, sorry. I mean, I just had a strange thought. But no, that would be crazy. Way too unlikely. Well, I'd like to speak freely, but I'm bound to my agreement with the Holy Order. However, I will tell Constantine and Old Aranthiel about my theory. And you will probably have to be patient until the latter decides to put you in the picture. Sorry. But if my idea is correct, then we'll be in a position to really kick ass. Anyway, hold still for a moment. Ready? All right, let's do this. Don't worry, it'll just tickle a bit. Fuck! Are you all right? That wasn't on purpose. Really. Oh my, you really do look terrible. I will make this right, I promise. I have no idea what just happened. The ritual isn't exactly harmless, but normally you shouldn't feel more than a weak tickle at most, regardless of how it goes down. But, maybe this has something to do with the strangeness of your aura. I already said this, but it's so different. It's hard to explain. Somehow complex and cold, maybe. But hey, I'm probably just out of practice. It worked, and that's what matters. Your fever will now settle down to an endurable level, and maybe even vanish if you're careful. And now I suggest you return to Constantine. I will get the stones to safety in the meantime. You need anything else? If not, see you later. We're going to meet again. I can feel it. Well, put simply, they're supposed to protect us, but Old Aranthiel will tell you more about it later. Take care.
Spiders. I wonder what the light one was thinking when they created them.
Help you with coming from Ark, aren't you? I can tell. Hello.
Walk blessed.
Thank you. Hmm? War on Nerim. War on Kile. Red madness. The fuck is wrong with this world?
What? Who are you? You shouldn't be here. This is my property. Oh, by the righteous path. Please, you have to believe me. I will fix this, and then I will sell for half the price. But please, my sir, I beg you, don't tell him the truth. No. That is... yes. In a way, I do. This cave here. These pathless spores. It's their fault. But I just don't understand why. I just don't. I'm sorry. I don't really know where to start. This drought, or whatever it is. I know what's causing it. Mushroom... spores. They come up from somewhere deep down in this cave here, and they draw life from the soil, the way a vatia sucks blood from a rabbit. But I can't get down there and destroy the mushrooms because this place is swarming with lost ones. So I can do nothing but stand here and see my entire life go to waste. It's like a curse, you know. A divine curse sent by Malthus to punish me for my sins. I even travelled into the city myself to get counsel from an alchemist. And now I know for sure. These spores, they're the same as the ones that have blighted the Whisperwood. If you tear out one mushroom, there'll be another one within an hour. I've heard that clusters can be exterminated by destroying their mother shroom. But as I said, I can't go down there, not with the lost ones inside. No pennies, no hope. Oh, by Malthus. I just don't know what to do anymore. What? But why would you do that? I see. I suppose I've a penny or two left. If you destroy the mushrooms, you'll have them.
Given up hope. Before we take this conversation any further, I hardly have any money left, so if you decide to help me, know that no riches await you. Fine. My daughter, Bea, she's sick. It happened about a moon ago. Fever, nausea, pain in all her limbs. Well, that's the thing. Old Marlin, the apothecary who took care of us farm folk, got mauled by a bear last year. He didn't make it. You can't imagine how bad it was. I tried everything, but nothing helped. Bea only got worse and worse. And who would have cared for Bea in the meantime? No, I couldn't leave her alone like that. Not for that long. Still sick. But you see, 2 weeks ago I met a traveler in the Red Ox. An apothecary. He didn't wear the yellow robes, but he undoubtedly knew his craft. I told him about Bea, and he offered to examine her, for free. Yes, Bea has belly worms. Yes, a rare illness from Kira. She must have gotten it from another coalman in the city, where she sells our harvest every week. The apothecary said that Endralean remedies wouldn't help, but that he knew a recipe because he had studied in Kira himself. Well, that's the thing. The ingredients are unusual, and I don't have the slightest idea where to get them. Here, take a look.
Monsieur?
Exactly. Look, my sir, I know times are tough, but if you can find the ingredients and brew this potion for me, I'd be eternally grateful. And of course, I'd pay you. Not much, but what I can afford. Really? I appreciate that. Malphus himself must have sent you. If you're a traveler, you surely have a map with you, don't you? Let me see. Here, this is my farm. Just go there once you have the elixir brewed. I'll be waiting. And again, thank you.
Monsieur?
What would you like to hear? Sure.
Hundred men they were, as they set out to fight for their country's banner in distant foreign lands. He bid her farewell, a love still young and
dream.
She thought she'd soon
Rose
be
Paul.
In his arms
Anyone?
Again.
I can't believe it, you again.
He told her, await my safe return, trust in this. Let's promise and stand firm once moonlight shines red onto the seas. We shall return in victory. They marched off, blue banners in the sky, and teardrops were running from her eyes. Yet she thought, if only I believe, time will bring him safely back to me. When the red moon casts its light, his ghost travels through the night, through the forest on wind's wings, until he reaches the old hill. There she kneels before his grave, where their love had once been born, and and he caresses her face, yet she feels not his embrace. Dark and red glows the winter sky, two souls divided by the threads of time. Days turned into weeks, moon for moon passed by, yet no word from the battlefields arrived. Months turned into years, peace now ruled the lands, empty graves were dug under the sky. Yet never did she doubt his last oath. Each night she stepped out into the cold. She walked through the forest, climbed the hill where she had once sworn her love to him. And always, when summer bid goodbye and moonlight, blood red fell from the sky. His ghost raced from dust forgotten bones, searching for what he had lost too soon. When the red moon casts its light, his ghost travels through the night, through the forest on wind's wings, until he reaches the old hill. There she kneels before his grave, where their love had once been born, and he caresses her face, yet she feels not his embrace. Dark and red glows the winter sky, two souls divided by the threads of time. Decades had gone by, her hair ashen and thin. Realms had fallen, worn, dead, forgotten.
Me, Stew, roast pork.
When she walked the streets, they said that she was damned, a victim to a past long gone and rotten. Yet still she did not care for their words. When night came, she prayed for his return. Each fall when cold winds haunted the land, she longed to once again hold his hand. And as her last sunset drew close by, she lingered, forgotten in the night. The moon's light shines bright upon her face. She's waiting as her life fades away. When the red moon casts its light, his ghost travels through the night, through the forest on wind's wings, until he reaches the old hill. There she kneels before his grave, where their love had once been born. And as she closes her eyes, a ray of light breaks through the sky, and her skin turns into dust as her soul breaks from its shell. And she joins him in the sky, two sheets freed from grief and time. Then the winds take them away, through the woods its trees sway. And she takes him by his hand, at last in peace they find their end. Dark and red glows the winter sky.
Huh? What do you want?
Two souls divided by the threads of time. Dark and red glowed the winter sky, two souls united by the threads of time.
Malfas's blessing.
A little bit of this and that. Why not take a look?
May your path always be even.
Beautiful and proud, the ruler of
walk
the
blessed, my child. How may I help you?
She was feared and desired, beggars, thieves, and murderers, the falling at her feet.
What would you like to hear?
Sure.
Maid, stew, roast pork. Anyone?
Listen, my child, and always remember the tale that struck fear in the hearts of so many. Summer it was, the day had just broken.
Walk blessed, my child. How may I help you?
A sight most unspoken. Sleep, sweet child, close your eyes. The
ravens
come to claim its prize. Can you hear his wings in the night? Hush, my darling, don't you fight. Do you cry? Oh, what for? You'll be free forevermore. Step out of your flesh, higher and higher. Your sins will be paid, we'll snuff out the fire. Stitched together, only a note was sewn to the tatters, rolled up and sealed the parchment like leather. Sleep, sweet child, close your eyes. The ravens come to claim its prize. Can you hear his wings in the night? Hush, my darling, don't you fight. Do you cry? Oh, what for? You'll be free forevermore. Step out of your flesh, float higher and higher. Your sins will be paid, we'll snuff out the fire. Ooh, 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 ooh. The keepers they met to open the letter, 10 priests and a prayer. The seal was untethered, the keeper he paled, for the note only said of the raven and the child and the sins we must pay. Do you cry? Oh, what for? You'll be free forevermore. Step out of your flesh, float higher and higher. Your sins will be paid, we'll snuff out the fire. Ooh, 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 ooh.
What would you like to hear?
Mead, stew, roast pork. Anyone?
Sure.
Do you know the aged man of whom no one knows? From whence he came, his house lies on the edge of a solitary cliff. Glow of death and pallid light illuminate the dark.
What idiot? For one, it is the... It also tells us the virtue of the path. The eye... You are welcome, child. Walk blessed.
A foreigner. At his door, say farewell to our
world.
They were only 200 people strong when Martha saw the dam to come along. Follow on my path to another land where happiness and peace forever dwell. They left and sailed across the mighty sea. They suffered hunger, fear, and misery. Their stocks were running low, yet they endured their woe, praising Malthus' wisdom day by day. Go and find the crimson star. It leads you to waters dark and ancient monsterous, born from malice either to the bone. One might have the fight, he sacrificed his life for his people.
Malthus's blessings. Malthus's blessings.
Keep your path and all the blind. And one day,
huh? What do you want?
Walk in the light. In deepest, blackest night, the God called out. Their shouts of
Malthus's blessings. Malthus's blessings.
On another world. See it shine, the crimson star. It lasts.
Huh? What do you want? Malthus's blessings. Huh? What do you want?
Mead, stew, roast pork. Anyone?
Monsieur?